lunch break. Let's now talk about spiritual workout, session 4. As we continue talking about this. What in the world is God doing in my life? Okay, now again, that's an important question. Kanina, tinanong natin sarili natin. Okay, why did God save you? Right? And at the same time, how do you glorify the Lord sa buhay mo? Now we come to another question, what in the world is God doing in my life? Now why is that important? Well, kasi like I said kanina, to glorify the Lord, ang kailangan mong gawin is to cooperate with Him. Eh kung di mo alam anong ginagawa niya sa buhay mo, how do you cooperate with God? Besides, posible na may ginagawa si Lord sa iyo right now na hindi mo alam kasi hindi ka aware. And instead of cooperating with God, baka mamaya kumukontra ka pa kay God. And in the same way naman nag-disciple ka ng isang tao, sometimes we're so helpful, hindi natin alam na yung pagtulong natin may be contradicting whatever God is doing in that person's life. Kasi there is a season for everything. Sometimes it's not time to help. Sometimes ang time talaga is to let that person be and experience yung failure na yun para he or she can understand kung ano ang grace of God. Hindi yung parang kawating kibot, tulong ka ng tulong. Really, need wisdom, di ba? Sa ganyan mga bagay. So, really, answering this question is so important kasi pag alam mo ito, then maiintindihan mo how to walk with the Lord every day sa buhay mo because, really, God is at work sa life mo. He sabi sa Bible, He is at work in you to make you willing and able to fulfill His will. Amen ba yun? Right, so this is a good question. What in the world is God doing in my life? Which is to say, what is God's goal in my life? Ano ba ang gusto ng gawin ni Lord sa buhay ko? Okay? If you are going to boil it down into its most basic concept, how would I know that I'm really, living my life in such a way na talagang, nandun ako sa tamang lugar talaga, as far as God is concerned in my life. Well, here's the verse I want you to read. Sabi ni Apostle Paul in Ephesians 4:20-24, you, however, did not come to know Christ that way. Now, he's referring to sa lifestyle na parang pariwara previous to this verse. Surely you heard of him and were taught in him in accordance with the truth that is in Jesus. So Paul is assuming na yung mga kausap niya, narinig nila yung gospel, narinig nila kung ano ibig sabihin itong gospel na ito, at tinuruan sila about Jesus and His purpose and so forth and so on. So based on that, sabi niya ganito, you were taught with regard to your former way of life to put off your old self which is being corrupted by its deceitful desires. We'll talk more about that later on. In other words, mayroon kang part dito. You are to put off. Hindi si Lord na mag-put off noon, ikaw mag-put off noon. Pero yung desire to put it off and the ability to put it off comes from God. Pero ikaw ang gagawa. God gives you the willingness. God gives you the ability. Pero you decide. In other words, may power ka na magbago kasi si Lord ay nasa sa iyo. Pero kung hindi mo pinipili yun, hindi mangyayari yun. Amen? I mean, God wants you to be a loving person and He's going to give you the ability to be a loving person. He's going to give you the desire to be a loving person. Lahat ang kakailangan mo para maging loving person, ibibigay niya. Ang sa'yo lang is to choose to obey Him. Amen? And you discover yung power na yun as you obey. Para katulad ng incident na one time si Jesus and the apostles were going to another place, coming from one side of the lake to another side of the lake. Sabi ni Jesus, we'll go to the other side. Pero ang ginawa niya, pinauna na muna niya mga disciples. Nag-pray muna siya, and then later on sumunod siya. Kaya lang, nandun na nga siya, may storm. Takot yung mga disciples, okay? And then, basically he appeared, okay? Walking on the water. No, I don't think there was a storm. He was walking on the water. Nag-appear siya na parang ghost. So sabi ni Peter, Lord, ikaw pa yan. Di ba? So sabi ni Lord, oo. Hindi naman ganun, pero parang ganun na sa Lord. Okay? And, so sabi ni Peter, Gana ano man yan, di ba? Pwede ba akong pumunta dyan sa'yo, di ba? Nasa Greek yata. So, sabi ni Jesus, oh, di ka niya, di ba? Tarolets, okay? So, si Peter, in obedience to God, nasabi ni Jesus, halika, he stepped out of the water, at nung nag-step siya sa water, hindi siya lumubog, and he started walking toward Jesus. Now, you know the story, lumubog siya, eventually, kasi natakot siya. But please, as the story continues, kung binasa mo, binawakan siya ni Jesus, as bumalik sila ulit sa bangka, and how, paano sila bumalik? Nag-swimming, hindi naglakad pa rin. So, St. Peter was the only one who walked on the water twice. Coming to Jesus and then going back to the boat. Okay? So, siguro, pag upo niya rin sa boat, tinitingnan niya yung mga disciples, parang, sign na yun. Right? Kasi, dalawang beses ka naglakad eh, no? But anyway, how did he experience walking on the water? By stepping out of the boat. So, in the same way, hindi mo may experience the power of God in your life unless you step out of the boat, step out of your comfort zone, obey God. Kung sinabi niya sa'yo, I want you to do this, do it by faith, then may experience by His power at work in your life. Okay? So, you were taught with regard to your former way of life to put off your own self, which is being corrupted by its deceitful desires, and then sabi niya, to be made new. Na yung tense o yung ano, voice nitong word na ito, voice means either active or a passive voice, or middle voice, this is passive voice, to be made new in the attitude of your mind. Hindi ibig sabihin na to make yourself new, to be made new, passive voice, those of you na present tense English 101, it means may ginagawa sa'yo, to be made new. Hindi yung ikaw ang gumagawa sa sarili mo para maging new. Alright? To be made new in the attitude of your minds and to put on the new self created, passive voice, to be like God in true righteousness and holiness. So, ano ginagawa ni Lord sa life mo? He is transforming you into the image and likeness of God in Christ Jesus. And ang project ni Lord sa life mo, alam mo yun? Think about that. Every day sa buhay mo, God is doing His mighty work. Mystery yan. Ito, kung binasa mo sa Bible, sometimes ang metaphor na ginagamit sa spiritual growth eh, parang yung kapanganakan, yung conception. Diba? I mean, it's so mysterious. Pag inisip mo yung paano nabubuo ang bata, galing sa embryo ba talaga? Embryo, you know, and then, diba, zygote muna, and then, diba? Although, siyempre, pag nakita mo, ay, mga tao, you know, cute, di ba? Pero parang nangyari yun, you know, parang nagkabit-kabit yung mga, you know, tapos, di ba, yung ilong dinapot sa tenga, you know, yung kamay, you know, it's so mysterious, di ba? Another analogy would be yung caterpillar. Okay? Yung ginagamit yung word na metamorpho or metamorphosis. You know, it's wonderful. Isipin mo, papasok, you know, uod, caterpillar, hindi, papasok siya doon sa ano, you know, parang upod niya na gano'n, and then lalabas siya, a totally different kind of creature. And then lilipad-lipad na siya doon, di ba? Tapos uuli siya ng mga bata, pag-iwiwala yung bakbak. God is working in my life to make me like Him and like His Son. I like that. That's awesome. Okay? So, caution. God at work. The last thing na dapat gawin ng isang mananampalataya is to live his life unconcerned and indifferent to the work of God in his life or her life. Napaka-tragic yan. For to live your life na hindi ka nagre-reflect and you are not self-aware and you are not seeking to know what God is doing, that's tragic. What a waste. Okay? Instead of dapat ang buhay mo as a disciple of the Lord is to somehow, you know, create a certain kind of rhythm sa buhay mo so that you're always time na ikaw ay gumagawa, nagme-ministry, na parang tuliro ka, nakatid mo, hindi ka manasa ng utak mo, lumilipad, ay ko ako sa'yo, tumigil ka muna. Okay? Mahanap ko muna ng a place of refuge and collect yourself. Focus. Kasi God is not after activity, God is after transformation. Okay? So, God is interested in life change. And He is at work in your heart. He's at work in your heart. That's where the project really is going on to this very day and will just continue to go on all the rest of your life. Heart transformation, mga kapatid. Because dyan lahat nagagaling. Out of the heart and of everything, the issues of life, stream four. Yung mga decisions mo, discarding mo, feelings mo, yung paradigm mo, yung way of looking at life, all of that emanates from the heart. Kaya pag ang heart mo hindi in tune with God, mali yung mga decisions mo, mali yung mga reasoning mo, mali yung mga paraan mo, yung feelings mo, wala sa lugar, and so on, imo ka, and la 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 la. Okay? But if you are right with God and your heart is right with God, remember what the Lord said to David regarding David's Abinah. Here is a man after my own heart. Imagine that. Si God mismo ang testifies tungkol sa iyo. And you are after His own heart. Yan dapat maging desire ng puso natin, mga kapatid. For our hearts to be in tune with God. That's my heart's desire. To be in tune with God. Kasi alam ko, when I'm in tune with God and God is He's working in me, alam ko, I'm able to preach better, I'm able to teach well, I'm able to behave well, I'm able to love my wife, I'm able to love my children, I'm able to resist temptation, I'm able to do all things that God wants from me whenever my heart is right before the Lord. Pag wala ako sa ayos, wala rin sa ayos na. And I know that. Kaya nga mga kapatid, one of the most important things na magagawa natin sa isa't isa is to really help each other be self-aware of what's going on in this other's heart. And the life group and all these groups are not meant to be simply parang barkadahan lang, you know, doing things together, kainan lang dyan. But really to be a place for us to be, you know, sharpening one another as iron sharpens another iron. Diba? And I'm so sad kapag nakakita mo ng mga grupo, mga life groups, or fellowship, na hindi nila ginagawa ito. They think it's all about having fun, nakwadya dito, noon ng dark night, or ng born legacy, or kain ng budil-budil, you know, whatever it is. Okay, no, which is okay, no problem, maganda yan. Okay? But then, these are just simply the context dapat for you to be able to be transparent, sa isa't isa, to lay down your masks, to be able to receive truth to one another. Okay? And all the problems in the church, kahit ano pa yan, emanates from heart issues. Kaya kapag ang isang ministry, busy-busy, like praise team alimbawa, busy-busy sa tuktok, practice, and they're not guarding their hearts, wala rin power yung music, wala rin power yung worship. This false flag. Like a singer, you know, you're not a minister. You know, there's a preacher, youth leader, I don't care kahit ano kaya. Kung wala yung heart mo sa tamang lugar, you will not be able to minister in the power of the Holy Spirit to bring about life change sa mga taong minimistero. Okay. So how is God doing this? First of all, it's by the Spirit of God. Here's what the Bible says concerning this. 2 Corinthians 3, 17-18, ganito po ang sinasabi. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And we who with unveiled faces, that's of course, you know, alluding to Moses, who nandun siya sa mountain, kasi sinabi ni Moses, okay, you know, that what we sinabi ni Moses, it was revealed in the scriptures that Moses was able to meet with God, and every time he met with God, he faced him and she shined, you know. And so Moses was that guy na meron siyang parang audacity. iyo lakas ng loob na sabihin, show me your glory, Lord. Wow, stig, huh? Show me your glory. And God did that, you know, wonderfully. Maganda yung story niya. But sabi niya, mas greater pa tayo kay Moses. Because si Moses, even though he was encountering God, tuwing mawawala siya sa presensya ng Panginoon, medyo nawawala na rin yung shining aura ng kanyang face and has to somehow cover it and all of that. Anyway, sabi niya, we who with that veiled faces all reflect the Lord's glory. So ngayon, iba, if you're a Christian and the Spirit of God is inside of you and with you, He is working in your life, sabi niya, are being transformed, present tense. Amen. Being transformed, lagi. Passive voice, pero lagi. No? Ongoing. Into His likeness. With ever-increasing glory. Can you imagine that? Araw-araw may ginagawa ang Spirit of God para maging kamukha mo lagi si Lord. You know? Sa character mo, sa personality mo, sa attitudes mo, sa relationships mo. I mean, if you're just cooperating with Him, you'll become more Christ-like over time. Okay? Kaya lang din nagkakain niya talaga kasi hindi natin alam pa paano. So, being transformed into His likeness with every increasing glory, which comes from the Lord, who is the Spirit. So, basically, here's what is happening to buhay natin. The Holy Spirit has been given to us. He lives inside of us. So siya yung nagbibigay sa atin ng mga bagong desires, bagong orientation. Whenever narinig tayo ng Word of God, siya yung nag-reveal sa atin ng illumination para maintindihan natin yun. Okay? And so forth and so on. So the Holy Spirit is just working sa atin, okay? To produce in us the kind of image. By the way, yun ang dahilan, bakit tayo na ayon gumagawa ng tao ng image. Diba? Pinagbabawal ng idolatry. Alam niyo bakit? Because man is the image of God. Man is supposed to reflect the image of God. He doesn't want man to make another image of God. Because ang gusto niya, yung man would reflect the image of God. Grabe, diba? Okay, now, another thing that he uses is of course the Word of God. Kaya nga, sa pag-araw-araw natin buhay, the more that we neglect yung daily input natin sa Word, you know, either reading it or studying it or whatever, meditating on it, memorizing it, kung ano man yung paraan na, maraming klaseng paraan, and we'll learn more of that later on. Pero, you know, mahalaga ang Word of God sa life natin. Here's what the Bible said. Okay? All Scripture is God-breathed. Okay? And is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness. So that the man of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. I told you that to glorify God is to cooperate with God in order to accomplish your good works na gusto niya ma-accomplish mo. So, tanong, how does that happen? Through the Word of God. I actually write more or less on a daily basis, a daily devotional. Sometimes nakakamiss ako, pero I write a daily devotional. I hope naka-subscribe kayo doon. I have about 37 subscribers ngayon. So, praise the Lord for that. Dati wala, ngayon 37. So, sino man yung mga tao ngayon, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Okay? But I write my devotional and I hope that you would subscribe. Para at least man lang makastart ka doon, read something. But then, of course, marami mong paraan talaga. Okay? For you to get into the Word. Okay? Mag-reflect kayo. So, napakahalaga. The Word of God is what God is doing. And so, dapat mo yung life mo in such a way na, you know, di napapabayaan niya. No? I remember when I was a new Christian. Lahat ng pagkakataon where I can hear the Word or learn from the Word, lagi ako na doon. I was so hungry, so thirsty. Sabi ni Peter, like newborn babes, sabi niya, crave for spiritual milk. Pagiging isang tao, born again kasi yan. Lalo na pagbago-bago yan. Talagang natulong sa kanya na magkaroon siya ng hunger and thirst for the Word of God. And kapag spiritual ang isang tao, tuloy-tuloy ang hunger niya, laging meron. So, mapapansin mo pag spiritually, ano ka, parang lukewarm ka, nawawala ng desire for prayer, nawawala ng desire for the Word. Ang nagpatuloy ka sa lukewarmness mo, mamaya mo pati, wala ka talaga desire for anything particularly about God. So, dinotorture din yung desire niya. Hindi yan parang lagi nangyayari. Pwede tumating yung time na parang yung desire mo for God, sa work niya, lahat-lahat, pwede mamatay yun eh. Pwede parang wala na, halos yung kumukuti-kutitak na lang niya sa heart mo kasi dinotorture yan eh. Pinapantayan niya, pinapay pa yan. Okay? You fan into flame, you know? The passion of God. Someone would come to me and say, Pastor, parang dry na dry ako. Talaga, anong ginagawa mo kasi? Wala ko yun. Nasagot. Wala kasi ginagawa eh. Akala mo, yung pagiging spiritually aflame for God, nangyayari lang by accident. Okay? Hindi yan nangyayari by accident. If you want to be spiritually on fire for the Lord, you have to do your part. Okay? To the point that sometimes you have to rearrange your life, say no to something. Pangatlo po is the people of God. God is using people to change us, transform us. Sabi nga nito, Ephesians 4:15-16, instead speaking the truth in love, we will in all things grow up into Him who is the head, that is Christ. From Him the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love as each part does its work. Belonging to a community of faith, belonging to a small group, belonging to a mentoring relationship, napaka-crucial yan sa paglago natin. If you want, God will really have access sa buhay mo. And of course, included na rin dyan pati yung mga thorns in the flesh sa life mo. Okay? Kasi hindi lang naman mentors ang nakakatulong sa'yo, pati tormentors. Okay? So give thanks to the Lord. Kasi sabi, my grace is sufficient for you. So kung may tao sa paligid mo na tormento na pinag-pray mo na sana, kunin na siya ni Lord, huwag mo ipag-prayan. Kasi malamang hindi ka sasagutin mo, Lord. Kahit tatlong beses pa ipag-prayan. Okay? It's my grace is sufficient for you. And then, of course, finally, is the sovereignty of God. And this has to do with experiences of buhay natin that we may not like. Maaaring hindi natin wini-welcome yan. Trials, testings, temptations, and of course, yung malupit, tribulations. Tribulations would be those particular times or days na concentrated ang evil attack sa buhay. Okay? Kumbaga, yun yung mga times na yung testing, trials, testings, and temptations nasa 10th power. You know? Naka-maximize. Okay? Yun yung panahon ng tribulation. Okay? And these experiences are permitted by the Lord. Not necessarily coming from God, pero everything that happens in life is by His sovereign will. So everything works together for the good. Kaya ang isang tao na mananampalataya should be self-aware na even yung ganyan mga negative na bagay, even yung nagkaroon kayo ng away, di ganito at di ganyan, na nagkaasaran kayo, that's part of the goal. Okay? Even yung incident na frustrate ka sa bahay, yung incident na nawala ka ng cellphone, yung incident na may nawala sa buhay mo is very close to your heart. All of these incidents are part of the molding process that God is using sa buhay mo. Amen? Amen? To transform you. So, the Spirit of God is at work. Learn to listen, cooperate with Him. Learn to have times of meditation para you can pray and listen to God. Huwag ka masyadong busy at huwag masyadong pagulin ang sarili mo to the point na pinag-pray ka, ilang segundo pa lang tulog ka na. The Word of God is at work in you. So pag umakatay ka ng church, magdala ka ng notebook. You know, magdala ka ng recorder kung hindi ka marunong magsulat. Okay? Okay, magdala ka ng tao magaling magsulat. Ilibre mo para isulat niya yung mga dapat niya isulat para sa'yo. Now, the people of God, that's all part of the mix. Get involved in authentic, life-giving relationships. And then the sovereignty of God, it's all part of the whole thing. All of life is sacred, all of life is spiritual. Kaya mag-aware ka dyan, then you know that you need to walk with the Lord every day. Okay? So, remember that there's always an area of concern, and the Holy Spirit knows that. It may be an area na pinaglalaban sa thoughts mo. God wants you to look into. Maybe hindi ka aware, but your thought life medyo nawawala na sa ayos. Lagi mo nang ini-imagine si ganitong artista o si ganitong artista na nakatake mo siya, you know. Maybe your attitudes are wrong. Masyado ka self-centered. Kaya pa na yung conflicts mo. So God is dealing in that area for you, so pay attention. Move your fulcrum to that place in your life. Ask God to just deal with you in that area. Maybe it's about your feelings. Maybe kung ano yung mga nararamdaman mo. Maybe you feel dry. Maybe you're going through a dark night of the soul. Pay attention to that. Kung parang dry yung feeling mo habang nagpipray ka, that is what God is doing in your life. Be self-aware. Maybe it has to do with your speech. Dahil ka nakakasakit. Kasi kung magsalita ka, parang kang bulldozer. You speak your mind. Sure, totoo yun. Kaya lang, what is inside your mind is not very edifying. So don't speak your mind. Siguraduhin mo na what is inside your mind is edifying before you speak it out. Minsan may kanalaman sa behavior mo. May mga ginagawa ka na nakasakit sa iba, nakasira sa iyo, nakadami sa relationships. O kaya maybe siguro tapat ka lang talaga, tulog ka ng tulog. Maybe that's something you need to change. Your relationships mo. Okay? Maybe yun ang may problema or your ministry. Mapalpak yung ministry mo ay sumasakit ang ulo mo, but maybe that's where the Lord is dealing with you. Sa area na yun. Maybe God is saying, look at your ministry. Pinababayaan mo. Binibigyan ng atensyon. Binibigyan mo lata. Ang energy mo. Kaya tuloy, nagkakaroon ng resulta hindi maganda. So sometimes, kung mga negative na bagay, senyalis yun for you to pay attention. Move your fulcrum. Move it. Yung fulcrum mo, yung bato na yung nilalim, yung heart mo. Move there. Pay attention. And you know, there are certain disciplines for you to do that, you know. Para maka-listen ka to the Lord. Maybe it has to do with your family. Sometimes meron nangyayari sa marriage. Sometimes may nangyayari sa relationships sa mga anak. Pay attention. Sometimes it's work. Sometimes may mga issue nangyayari sa trabaho mo that God wants you to look at. School. So you see, there's no place in life and yet works the Lord in your life. Okay? Maybe it's about your health. Manayikain mo ng balat ng mato. So, tataka ka ba? Parang masama pangiramdam mo. Kasi kain ka na tayo ng balat ng mato. Or chicha. Or di ka natutulog. Okay? And so, dami, okay, okay, hindi mo patamblay ako. Well, you know, maybe God is telling you, sleep. Or what? What is it that the Lord is dealing with? God is at work in your life. Pay attention. So I want you to go back to your groups again for the next 15 minutes, back to time of break. I want you to just, you know, take a moment to examine kung ano nangyayari, sa kama may pressure, sa kama mayroong education, sa kama parang na kukonsume, sa kama parang na tension or stress. And then share it with the group. Maybe that's an area that God wants you. Okay? Let the others respond. You can ask questions too.